Federally recognized tribes have a unique opportunity in rural areas to directly access unassigned spectrum over their tribal lands. The 2.5 GHz band is suitable for both mobile coverage and fixed point-to-point uses, and is currently used to provide broadband services by both legacy educational licensees and commercial providers who lease the spectrum. The purpose of the 2.5 GHz rural tribal window is to allow federally recognized tribal nations to apply for licenses on rural tribal lands where there is unassigned spectrum available, before the unassigned areas of spectrum are auctioned. Depending on the tribe's needs, it can play an important role in the deployment of broadband and other advanced communication services. Applicants in the priority window may designate their own desired license areas so long as the entire area is rural tribal land and the applicant has a local presence in the area. Rural means an area is not part of an urbanized area or urban cluster area with a population equal to or greater than 50,000, according to the Census Bureau data. Tribal land, for this purpose, means any federally recognized tribe's reservation, including former reservations in Oklahoma and Alaska Native regions established pursuant to the Alaska Native Claims Settlement Act or Indian allotments, but not including off-reservation lands. To find out if a tribal nation has available spectrum over its tribal land, the FCC has provided a mapping tool to allow for preliminary research. To begin this research, please visit www.fcc.gov/rural-tribal-window. Once the page loads, it is important to read through all of the material to get a better understanding of how to view and read the maps. On the page, you will find general information, application information, data source, events, releases, and for the purposes of this video, maps. Click on the Maps tab, and then the Mapping Tool button. When the page loads, there is a set of helpful instructions on how to use the Tribal Land Search tool and navigate the map once they load. There are two ways to use the Tribal Land Search function. First, you can scroll through the list of tribal lands listed in alphabetical order, or you can begin typing in the text box a specific tribal land name. Once a tribal land has been located, click the link in the middle box. You will get a box that states that you are leaving the FCC website. Just click OK and you will see the mapping tool begin to load. Please understand that this mapping tool can be used by tribal entities to help them assess whether and to what extent there is unassigned 2.5 GHz spectrum available over their eligible tribal lands. The mapping tool provides a high-level view of spectrum availability and allows users to link to the FCC's Universal Licensing System to confirm the exact amount of eligible spectrum available. ULS can also be accessed directly at www.fcc.gov/ULS. Click OK. Once the map loads, you will see an outline of the selected tribal land and the surrounding area. To enhance this view, we are going to go to the bottom right of the screen under the heading Query Criteria. Here, you can click on Task and then type in the name of the tribe below. Select the correct map and hit Apply. Now the tribal area will be highlighted by a blue line to provide a more distinct outline as we explore how to use the mapping tool. To view the map from different vantage points and to be able to move around the map, we will start on the top left-hand corner, where we will see a set of squares with icons. A four-square icon, when selected, provides different base maps such as topography, imagery, and street map views. To select a specific base map, click on the selected image and the underlying map should change. You can also view the entire map by clicking the home icon, which will zoom out to show the continental United States. To move the map, hover the cursor over the map, left-click the mouse, and hold and drag the map to different areas. If you want to zoom in, use the plus and minus icons. If you would like to go back to a previous area that you were looking at, you can use the arrow icons to go back and forward like you do in an internet browser. Finally, a bookmark icon allows you to set a bookmark and/or return to any previously saved bookmark. On the right-hand side of the map, you will see a layers list with checkboxes. Each of these checkboxes represents a layer of data that will be depicted on the map visually. Starting with our query result as the first layer, there should also be two layers selected showing what is eligible and ineligible. To the right of these layers, you will see a legend that provides visual information that corresponds with the layer selected on the map. The first three legend icons that we see are eligible rural tribal lands, query results, eligible rural tribal lands, and ineligible tribal lands, which is represented by boundaries containing slashes, such as this area. These ineligible areas, regardless of whether they are incumbent licenses or not, are not available because they are considered urban areas. If we move to the urban areas with populations greater than 50,000 layer, we will see that the ineligible tribal lands icon is now highlighted in purple, as are other areas outside of the tribal land. To find out what is available, we must move through the following layers that correspond with different channels. You can select channel 1, or 2, or 3 checkboxes to see a heat map of existing license holdings for each channel. On the right hand side, the legend will correspond to the color shown on the map. The lighter the color, the less spectrum is currently licensed, which indicates greater availability for a tribe. For more information on a spectrum's availability, you can select a specific channel and click on the specific area of the map, like so. When we click channel 1, we see that the western portion of the Isleta tribal land is a light color, and when the information box pops up, we find there is no entity licensing that area. However, if we click on the eastern part of the land in red, we can see from the 49.5 MHz number in the pop-up box that all 49.5 MHz on channel 1 is currently licensed and cannot be used by a tribal applicant. If the number of megahertz in the box is less than the total of spectrum in the channel, there is at least some unassigned spectrum available to be used. As stated before, this tool is a helpful visualization, but it is recommended that this be supplemented with licensed research in a specific area of what is available. For a more advanced view, you can look at the available spectrum by clicking the arrow at tool at the bottom of the page. Here, you will see that the tabs match up with each of the layers that we walked through on the right of the page earlier. However, with each channel expanded out into a table format, you can scroll through to see what frequencies are taken and then determine what might be available. To conduct further related research on a specific licensee in a specific area, find the ULS link on the right-hand side of the information window and click the link for more info. When you click the link from the mapping tool, you will be taken directly to the licensee's license information located in ULS license search. Once the page loads, you will be on the main tab, which contains important information such as dates, licensee, and contact information. Moving further down the page, you will see the channel plan section that refers to the legacy band plan that applies to existing licenses, not the new band plan that will apply to licenses granted through the tribal window and the auction to be held later. Moving to the market tab, you will see a list of counties that are at least partially covered by the license and the list of frequencies that are authorized. For a visual representation of the coverage in those areas, click on the Map tab. Here you will see the licensee's frequencies used within the coverage area. If the license has leased all or part of the spectrum or area, you can view the information by clicking on the Leases tab. To view the area and/or spectrum that has been leased, click on the lessee's license ID number. When looking at the lessee's information, you will notice that all of the information is set up like the licensee. For more detailed information regarding the 2.5 Rural Tribal window and the licensing requirements, please visit www.fcc.gov/rural-tribal-window. When you are on the page, be sure to check out the Events tab. Here you will see an updated list of upcoming workshops and events that may be relevant to you. For questions about an area's eligibility, please contact us at ruraltribalwindow@fcc.gov.